Last week I received two questions from two different person related to Raja Yoga. The first person have Malva Yoga, which means Venus exalted in Kendra, but his Venus Dasa is moderate. The second person have Jupiter exalted in fourth house, creating Hamsa Yoga, but his Jupiter Dasa is also moderate. So why this kind of Raja Yogas is not working at times? So that is the topic I am going to talk about today. The answer lies in the strength of the horoscope. So even before analyzing the Raja Yogas in the horoscope, it is very essential to access the strength of the overall horoscope. Any yogas will work to the extent in which the overall strength of the horoscope. So I am going to give 6 thumb rules to access the strength of the horoscope. First, the trine houses. So in astrology, first house, fifth house and ninth house are called trine houses. These trine houses are like the foundation of the horoscope. So similar to how the foundation is very important for a building, for a horoscope the foundation is very important. So the trine houses, first house, fifth house and ninth house, well placed, ensures that the horoscope have a very strong foundation. The next is Kendra. So in astrology, the first house, fourth house, seventh house and tenth house are called Kendra houses. So the Kendras are like pillars of the horoscope. So well placed first house, fourth house and seventh house and tenth house ensures that the horoscope have a strong pillars. The next one is Yogacaraka planet. Every ascendant have Yogacaraka planet. Probably I'll make a separate video to talk about Yogacaraka planet for each ascendant, but in this video let me give few examples. For example, for Leo or Cancer ascendant, Mars becomes the powerful Yogacaraka. For Taurus and Libra ascendant, Saturn becomes the powerful Yogacaraka. So when this Yogacaraka planet is well placed, that gives the additional strength to the horoscope. The fourth point is Lagna Lord. So as I already mentioned in my previous video, Lagna represents self. So when strong Lagna Lord is well placed, the person will exercise more hard work and he will come up in the life. The next one is the placement of Dustana Lords. So the 6th, 8th and 12th are malefics for any ascendant. Okay. So when this malefic becomes weak, that itself adds the strength to the horoscope. So there is a popular saying that the richest person is one who don't have any health issues. So in astrology, 6th house rules disease. So the 6th house without any affliction itself is a greatest gift to a person. So I would say the well-placed 6th house without any affliction is much better than having multiple Raja Yogas and afflicted 6th house. And the last important point is Dasa Bhukti. If you understand that Dasa Bhukti plays a major role in giving the results. So some of the planets have Dasa Bhukti extends up to 20 years. For example, Venus runs for 20 years, Saturn runs for 19 years, Jupiter runs for 18 years, so on and so forth. So when the particular Yogacaraka Dasa Bhukti comes in the middle life, then the person will have successful life. So let me summarize. Strong trine house ensures that the foundation of horoscope is very strong. Strong Kendra house ensures that the pillars of horoscope are very strong. The Yogacaraka planet well placed ensures that the horoscope have additional strength. The strong Lagna Lord makes a person to work towards a goal. The 6th, 8th and 12th house without much affliction is the greatest gift. The favorable Dasa Bhukti falling in the middle life will ensure that native will get success without much effort. So before even going to Raja Yogas, the budding astrologer should access all these points to access the strength of the horoscope so that we can comfortably conclude whether a Raja Yoga will confer a greater result, moderate result, or limited results. So before closing this video, so in case if the overall strength of the horoscope is good, there are several Raja Yogas, but even then, if the person is leading a mediocre life, then what is the problem? So the answer is simple. The person is not exercising more free will. I hope you enjoyed this video. So I'll come back with another interesting topic in my next video. Until then, bye.